Hello, good morning everyone. Today we are going to do class 8 science, chapter number 4, reproduction. As we have studied in our previous classes, that reproduction is the process by which living beings produce copies of themselves. So what is reproduction? Reproduction is the process by which living beings, remember, non-living beings cannot do this process. Living beings produce young ones of their own kind. In simple living organisms, reproduction takes place with the help of only one parent. That means either the male or the female. And this type of reproduction is called asexual reproduction. So if the question is asked, what is asexual reproduction? You will tell the mode of reproduction in which only one organism is required, either the male or the female, is known as asexual reproduction. That means there is no requirement of other partner in the asexual reproduction. But there are certain higher organisms, plants and animals, in which both male and female are required for the process of production of, for the process of formation of new organisms, copies of themselves. So such type of method is known as sexual reproduction. So how do we define sexual reproduction? The mode of reproduction in which both male and female individuals are required to produce young ones of their own kind are called or is called sexual reproduction. Next we have, our next topic is sexual reproduction in animals. So sexual reproduction means reproduction by the process of use of sex organs. So in animals we have two types, male and female. So the male gamete, that means the male sex cell, is called the male gamete. The male sex cell is called the male gamete, and the female sex cell is called the female gamete or the ovum, and the plural is ova. The male gamete is called the sperm, and the female gamete is called the ovum, plural ova or egg. So when the process of reproduction is done by living organisms, then the male gamete, that means the sperm, and the female gamete, that means the ovum, fuses to form zygote. And this process of fusion of the two sex cells, the gamete cells, is called fertilization. So this takes place in animals. This process also takes place in plants, but here we are talking about animals. So I told you the male gamete, sperm, and the female gamete, the ovum. Now our next topic is type of fertilization. Just now we saw the definition of fertilization, that the process of fusion of the male gamete and the female gamete is called fertilization. So now we will study about the two types of fertilization. The two types of fertilization are external fertilization and internal fertilization. External fertilization and internal fertilization. In some animals like fish, frog, Fertilization does not take place inside the body of the organism. That means the mode of fertilization in which the fertilization has taken place outside the body of the organism is known as external fertilization. So how this happen? How this fertilization takes place outside the body? That means the female will discharge egg and the male will discharge sperm. That means the female will give out egg out of their body, the male will give out sperm from their body, and the egg and the sperm will meet, will fuse outside their body. For example, in fish and frog, it will take place in water, as you can see in this diagram. The sperm swims to the eggs and fertilizes them. But there is another kind of fertilization, another type of fertilization, which we call it as internal fertilization. In internal fertilization, what happens? The fusion of the male sex cell or the male gamete, the sperm, and the female sex cell or the female gamete, ovum, takes place in the body of the female, inside the female's body. Then it is known as internal fertilization. For example, we human beings, lizard, crocodile, birds, mammals are such animals in which fertilization takes place inside the body of the female, and this type of fertilization is called internal fertilization. Mammals are animals that have babies which are nursed by their mothers. Other animals like birds, crocodile, snake and lizards lay eggs. There are some exceptional mammals like the platypus and the spiny anteater or the echidna. They lay eggs. However, these also nurse their young ones. Now we will start our next part, reproduction in man. Before going in detail, first we will study about the organs in the human reproductive system. So human reproductive system has been divided into two parts, two types, the male reproductive system and the female reproductive system. So first we will study about the male reproductive system. The male reproductive system, as you can see in the diagram, consists of the testes. This is the testes. This one is the testes, where the production of sperm takes place. Singular is testis and plural is testes. This is written testis, T-E-S-T-I-S. Testis is singular and T-E-S-T-E-S, testes, is plural. So whenever a boy child, a male, attains puberty, it starts producing sperm in this testes. So what is the puberty? When does puberty occur? Puberty occur or is attained by a male more or less at the age of 13 to 14 years. About detail you will study this all in upper classes 9 and 10. So our topic was or is the male reproductive system. So the male reproductive system consists of the testes, which is responsible for the production of the male sex cell, the sperm, and this testes is contained in a sac-like structure which we call the scrotum. Then there is muscular structure which we call the penis. There is epididymis. This is the place where the sperm is stored temporarily after the production by the testes. Then we have got the urethra. Here this pipe which is connected from the epididymis up to the urethra is called the vas deferens. This is the diagram of a sperm. This is the head part and this is the tail part. When a boy child attains puberty, it produces large number of sperm, and these sperms are temporarily stored in the epididymis, and then from that epididymis, with the help of the vas deferens, it travels towards the urethra, and in the meantime, the sperm gets mixed by the various secretions of the prostate gland, another gland, and then they mix together and we call them as the semen, and then it is secreted out through this urethra through the penis into the female's body, and in the female's body, in the female's reproductive organ, there is the egg, and then this male gamete sperm and the female egg fuses and fertilization takes place. Next we have got the female reproductive system. The female reproductive system consists of ovaries, fallopian tube, uterus and vagina. And the male reproductive system consists of testes, vas deferens, epididymis, penis and some glands. So now we will see about the female reproductive system. So in this system we will see that the ovaries are there. Here in this part you can see one ovary this side, other ovary the other side. And this is the female reproductive organ which is found in the lower part of the abdominal cavity of a girl. Whenever a girl child reaches puberty, that means almost the age of 10 to 12 years, then this ovary starts producing egg every month. Usually one of these ovaries produces one egg every month, and each ovary is a muscular tube which ends in the funnel. In this funnel. Each ovary is a muscular tube which ends in this funnel. This funnel is called the funnel of the fallopian tube, because this is the fallopian tube. This is also the fallopian tube. From both the side, as we saw in the case of male, there are two testes, and each testis is connected with epididymis. And each epididymis is again connected with the what you call the vas deferens, and both the vas deferens come and join at the urethra. In the same way here we will see in the female, both the ovaries are connected to the fallopian tube, this side also, and both the fallopian tube together again come and merge at this uterus and become one tube. See here, one tube coming this side, one tube coming from this side, but here we are seeing as a single. So in this part division had taken place, division has taken place. So this tube carries the ovum from the ovary to the uterus. This fallopian tube carries the egg. When the egg is secreted out from the ovary, either this or this, it comes to this part in the fallopian tube, and then when to this side, to the vagina, when the sperm comes to this part, it reaches here and the fusion takes place. When the fusion has taken place, then this zygote comes returns to this uterus and gets embedded, that we call implantation has taken place. In detail you will study in class 10. So fallopian tube, this one and this one, we also call them as the oviduct. So this uterus is a muscular organ. Its lower portion is called the cervix and is connected to the outside opening, which we call it the vagina. And this vagina receives the penis during the intercourse time, and there is transfer of sperm from this part into the female's body during the intercourse time. And then when this sperm reaches here and the egg has been released from the ovary and reaches to this part, or if egg has been released from this ovary here and the sperm reaches to this part, then fertilization takes place. And after fertilization, the plantation takes place here. We actually call it implantation. In detail, we will study in upper class. Now we will study the next topic, fertilization. So I told you here that when the egg and the sperm both fuse together, then what happens? Fertilization takes place. So how we will define fertilization? Fertilization is the fusion of the male gamete and the female gamete. And once the fertilization has taken place, it forms the zygote. So how do we define zygote? Zygote is the cell formed by the fusion of the male gamete and the female gamete. So when the zygote has been formed, after that what happens? They divide. Again and again they divide. And then they form embryo. And this embryo gets attached. This embryo gets attached in this in the wall of the uterus. In this uterus, in the wall of the uterus. And then after repeated cell division, after growth and development, this embryo changes into fetus, F-O-E-T-U-S, fetus, and then finally into baby. So what we will see in this part, that we will see about the fertilization that I explained you. The cells of the embryo divide and differentiate into different types to form tissues. The tissues form organs, and embryo slowly take the familiar form of a baby. This is when it is called fetus. So here it has been given to you. So you can understand in short in this way, that when fertilization has taken place, then it forms zygote. Zygote divide and redivide after fertilization and forms the embryo. The embryo gets implanted into the uterus, and there again it receives nutrition from the mother's body with the help of the umbilical cord, and then it grows and converts into fetus. And when this fetus develops its different organs, body parts, then it takes the shape of a baby, and we call it as a small baby. After fusion, zygote is formed, zygote develops to form embryo, embryo develops to form fetus, and fetus finally converts into a small baby. Till the birth has not taken place, we don't call it a baby, or we call it also no problem, but when for the birth of the child has taken place, we call it as a baby. In the mother's womb, we may call it as fetus. F-O-E-T-U-S, fetus. In this diagram, we all can see that there is egg. This is the nucleus of the egg. And then so many sperms are coming. But at a time, only one egg fuses with one sperm. See in the next diagram, one sperm fuses with one egg. One sperm fuses with one egg and then finally it forms a zygote. Then the zygote, the fertilized egg is called the zygote. And this zygote will turn into embryo, embryo into fetus, and fetus into baby. So I told you that when the fertilization has taken place, what happens? The embryo comes into the into the uterus of the mother and it gets implanted there. And in the wall of the uterus, in the mother's womb, there is presence of blood vessels. See, every month the uterus prepares itself to receive the fertilized egg. How it makes itself ready? By making a cushion, by making soft inner linings of blood vessels from inside. So when the embryo will come and get implanted in the uterus of the mother, then it will be connected with the help of a tube-like structure which we call the umbilical cord. Okay, and then through the placenta only, whatever waste materials are produced in the this fetus bodies or embryo's body or the baby's body, it is thrown out into the mother's blood, or whatever food or nutrition the baby, the growing child in the mother's womb requires, all are supplied to this umbilical cord. That you call the placenta to the baby. The baby, the embryo fetus, grows in the mother's uterus for about 9 months. Sometime we also see it is written 9 months 10 days. And this period of 9 months or 9 months 10 days is called the pregnancy period. It is also known as gestation, G-E-S-T-A-T-I-O-N. The time period from the fertilization up to the birth of the baby is called gestation. Okay, you all study nicely. Wish you all the best. Thank you. Next part we will see in another video.